I have to think of ideas for narration without moping around too much. So there is a child in a small room with no light, but he can see the outside. The room isn't necessarily scary, but what the child can see outside is terrifying to him. So then, the child seeks a safe haven in the corner of the room and then begins to build up confusion as to how will he escape, how will he get to the outside. And that to me is my definition of what depression feels like. I think I've been in the room for too long. My name is Jhovanny, I'm 17 years old, and I've been to Catholic schools all my life. I have to write ideas about how it feels to be depressed and explain that to another person. Two parents from the Dominican Republic having their first child here in the US. Since I was the first generation of my family being born in America, I actually had to live according to their lifestyles growing up. They just raised me the exact same way that they were raised, which could be pretty rough sometimes.
De la escuela pública que estaba en primero, lo cambié ese mismo año a la escuela privada. Y la primera semana le dieron examen.
Venía de una escuela pública prácticamente, muy diferente a una escuela privada.
Se frustró tanto, tanto, tanto que la primera semana sacó una F. Comenzamos a estudiar el lunes y terminamos el jueves y el viernes se sacó una A. Y nunca más volvió a sacar una F. Simplemente que él siempre le gustaba que las cosas le salieran perfectas. Y siempre quería que tuviera, que todo estuviera bien.
Failing a test feels like total rejection. I strive for perfection to avoid, especially people screaming at me, anyone that's working higher for me, like teachers or parents especially. I just want to get it right on the first time so that no one has to talk about it and it'll be done. The things I have to do, regardless of what they are, produce anxiety, and considering the fact that I procrastinate a lot, I just leave it until late at night, and then late at night, I decide, okay, I can do that in the morning, no biggie. Then comes the morning, I start panicking because I feel like it's gonna be the end of the world, everything's done, I'm a goner. Day by day, that starts creating the cycle of panic. But there are good days too. I remember this one day, I was sitting on my porch in front of my house, and I recall a lady walking down the street, talking really loud to her friend over her cell phone. She was talking about how she was done with an internship and that she finally got a job at this place. I didn't know what it was, I just felt happy for her though. While she was walking away, I yelled at her, "Congratulations," and she yelled back, "Thank you." That made me feel really good, and that was a good day.
Una de las cosas que siempre me hacía sentir mal era que cuando yo iba y tocaba la puerta de Jhovanny del cuarto de él y le preguntaba que si iba a la escuela, él me decía que no. Eso me subía la sangre, me enfurecía, me cambiaba.
That's the thing about depression. No one can really understand you but you. And it hurts when people close to you, especially people like either your family or your friends or even your girlfriend, whatever it may be, the only person that can understand you is yourself. And the only one that can help you out of that rut is yourself. You have to help yourself.
Pero en el décimo grado, en ese que estamos ahora, igual siguieron las faltas en la escuela y nosotros comenzamos a preocuparnos bastante. yo comencé a buscar ayuda en un hospital, consejería, terapia, para entender qué era lo que estaba pasando, porque yo no sabía cómo sacarlo de ese cuarto.
May 3rd, 2013 is a day that will live in infamy.
Que tenía que admitirlo en el hospital, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Dejarlo en el hospital por una o dos semanas en tratamiento a ver cómo... con terapia para ver cómo va a reaccionar.
The three most important things I learned from the psych ward include eye contact. It levels out the playing field with people, and just talking to them, it makes it incredibly a lot easier, and it removes a lot of anxiety when talking to people. Good posture is also really important. Don't lay your head on a table and pretend to be dead and that you don't want to be somewhere, because unfortunately you have to be at a certain place at a certain time. So just have a straight back and talk to people, because if you have good posture, you'll be easy to talk to. And lastly, moderation. Moderation is something really important, because if you don't control what amounts you do of certain activities, such as being on the computer, free time, working, playing sports, it can really overload you and cause a lot of stress in your life. I learned something really valuable on a podcast one day that I was listening to. I learned that to raise self-esteem, you must commit estimable deeds. And the day I congratulated that lady, I considered that an estimable deed. And I guess that's why I felt good about it afterwards. I can never really get rid of depression. It's more so how I can control it and continue to do anything I have to do, any assignment for like school or work or anything. I understand that I can never really get rid of these depressing lulls in my life. That's the thing with depression. It's a one day at a time sort of thing.